The committee chaired by the Butambala County Legislator Muhammad Muwanga Chivumbi had convened for an interface with the Minister of Tourism, Wildlife and Antiquities over audit queries flagged by the Auditor General in the financial year that ended June 2023. To the surprise of the committee, the accounting office of the ministry, Doreen Katosime, made no show without prior communication. These ACT committee members who accused Katosime for repeatedly dodging committee invitations. Chivumbi emphasized that the permanent secretary pulled a similar move last year and survived scrutiny.
She's an habitual absentee and gives all these manners of excuses for non-appearance. And that's why when she said she was not coming, did you communicate? When did you get a communication to appear?
I think the document arrived around the 5th of March.
5th of March, how many days from now?
That's about 10 days ago.
And on 7th, she goes for a leave?
Yes, sir. Annual leave.
Some committee members pleaded to fellow MPs to allow the meeting to proceed after Samuel Kakura, the undersecretary, confirmed that he had been delegated and had participated in producing response to the queries.
Accounting officers, you know, they delegate. The office remains there. To me, we could proceed if for him we can take the responsibility, personal responsibility, whatever outcome will come out of this.
And I think the committee, without much ado, has a legal opinion, has a direction on matters of this nature. And we're not going to massage it.
Goreth Namoga, the committee vice chairperson, however, protested the pleas and pointed Kakura to sections in the Public Finance Management Act 2015, which put the mandate to account exclusively on the accounting officers.
Being an habitual absentee from this committee, for me, I cannot say that his explanation is very genuine and sincere. Honorable Chair, being accountability, I do move that we stand this committee, we should not interface with them today. We give another date for the accounting officer to appear in person.
The committee chairperson was forced to dispatch CID police to accompany the undersecretary Samuel Kakura to the home of the under fire permanent secretary and produce her to the committee in 30 minutes.
I want to waste a lot of our time. You are going to stay here. Do you know where the accounting officer stays?
I've not reached her home.
No. Does anyone here know where the accounting officer stays?
I'm not.
You are going to stay here. I'm giving her criminal summons. CID, you accompany this accounting officer. Go to her home. Get her here.
However, the Undersecretary Kakura was hesitant to follow instructions of the committee, wondering how he could participate in the arrest of his boss.
You said what you are saying is on record. Can I also say something on record?
Have you known that I've given instructions and a rule?
But sir, I cannot go to PSC's house.
No, please, look. No, it's you. I'm sending you and police.
Police can go to her house.
When the committee reconvened after 4 hours of waiting, it was reported that police failed to trace her whereabouts and summons were extended up to Tuesday next week.
Informed us that the permanent secretary was not traceable. However, the undersecretary that was sent to look for her or to assist the CID in looking for the permanent secretary said that he was informed by the person who works at her home that she's in the village, she's in Nakaseke.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.